I was looking around here in Duna Arena, even more Croatian supporters arrived. There you can see the Spanish lineup, coached by David Martin. Two changes compared to the World Championships team. Barroso and Cabanas left out. Delgado, who was playing some years here in Hungary, OSC and Vasas, and Sanahuja are those two players who weren't there last year when Spain won the silver medal and the Olympic spot for this summer's Tokyo game. And these are the same two changes compared to the last European Championships 2 years ago. On the other side, the Croatians made also two changes comparing the last European Championship. Luka Bukic and Hrvoje Benic arrived to the team, while they made only one change compared to last year's World Championships. Bukic is the only new face in the Croatian team. So the last World Championship, Croatia won the bronze medal, Spain won the silver medal, and they met in the semi-final, and that time Spain won by 6-5. Here you can see the president of the LAN. And now let's see some results in the past in the European Championship, because it happened a really long time ago when these two teams meet in the European Championship, actually in Eindhoven, 8 years ago. And that time the match ended in a draw 8-8. The last Croatian win was at the same year. They won by 11-10. And the last time when Spain was able to beat Croatia in the European Championships, it happened 17 years ago when Spain beat Croatia 6-3. The historical head-to-head at the European show Croatia's absolute superiority with 5 wins in 7 games. So that is the only time when Spain managed to beat Croatia, happened in 2003, 17 years ago. They met last year in the World Championships, but they had some matches at the Olympics as well. Since the Croats entered to the Olympic Games in 1996 in Atlanta, they played their most notable match right away. The final, where Spain managed to beat Croatia by 2 goals. In Sydney, it was Spain again. They won by 1 goal in the quarterfinals. Then in Beijing, it was still Spain, 2 goals for the 5th place for Spain. Then in London, 8 years ago, Croatia won 8-7. Amid some controversy at the end. In Rio, it was Spain again. They won by 5 goals in the group stage. In the semi-finals, Spain made it 4 times. They won twice, once in 91, and in the last edition, 2 years ago, while the Spanish the Croatian team had mixed fortunes in the semi-finals. In 8 appearances, they had 3 wins and 5 losses. Now let's see the first semi-final of the 34th LAN European Championships. And the first possession goes to Croatia, wearing the blue cap. First shot and the first save of the match, Dani Lopez. The Croatian fans just behind me, so probably you will hear them even more than the Spanish supporters. One more Croatian shot, this time saved by the post. Nobody touched the ball. Now Spain has the ball and has the chance to score the first goal of the match. Spain beat Malta that made a draw against Hungary and then beat Turkey in the group stage. They finished second on goal difference behind Hungary. So they needed to make a quarterfinal qualification, but that was just an easy win against Germany. And then in the quarterfinals, they managed to avenge their 2018 final defeat against Serbia in the same way on the penalty shootout after 6-6 on the penalties, 4-3 for Spain. While Croatia draws in the first part of its mission with 3 wins, beat Germany, Montenegro and Slovakia. Actually, Montenegro was the closest match, of course, but the Montenegrin team was trailing by 5 goals on that group stage match, and they were able to come back, and they even had the chance to win that match against Croatia, but in the end Croatia won by 1 goal. And then an easy win against Slovakia, and then in the quarterfinal they just downed Greece by 3 goals, 14-11. Now this is a wrong pass, and Spain has the ball, still no goal after almost 2 minutes gone in this first semi-final. After this match, the second semi-final follow between the host Hungary and Montenegro. The first exclusion of the game, the number 11, Hrvoje Penić from Croatia. Now the pass to the left wing, back to the right. No chance to shoot from the tight angle, then from the middle, and saved by the post one more time. Verona passing, no goal. Just the side of the net. Still no goal between these two giants. Spain has never won the European Championship. They have 2 silver medals the last 2 years ago and 3 bronze medals. While Croatia won 1 gold medal on the home pool 10 years ago in Zagreb, plus 2 silver medal and 1 bronze medal. The last medal was the bronze 2 years ago, and here's the first goal of the match, scored by Croatia and Marko Macan. Croatia takes the lead. And only Marko Macan's second goal in the tournament. The top scorers from Croatia, the captain Andro Busilja with 9 goals, while from Spain is Álvaro Granados with 15 goals. Granados is the top scorer so far in the whole tournament, but only until this day. Majera. Try to pass to the center forward, and there is an exclusion from Croatia again. Marko Macan. Munariz. Back to Munariz. Now to the right. Still no shot, not even Majerak. Now to the center forward, and a great save made by the Croatian goalie. Sanaua was still fighting for the ball, but the ball goes to Spain, goes to Croatia, of course. Marko Macan is on 100%. Only 5 seconds on the shot clock for Croatia. Shot from the tight angle. Easy save for Dani Lopez. Exclusion while swimming back from Croatia. Already the 3rd exclusion from the Croatian team. This time Josip Vrlić. Majera. Harris, one more save. Marko Vujačić is on top form. At least he starts the match in that way. Croatia can have now a two-goal lead. So far there is no goal for Spain. But now only 3 seconds for Croatia to attack. And the shot saved by Dani Lopez, who was the best goalkeeper of the year last year, according to Len. The second best player in the world, actually. 39 years old, the oldest team member in the Spanish lineup. Saraúja, Mayera. Shot from distance, but just too high. Last year, the Spanish team not just won the World Championship silver medal, and with that the Olympic spot for the Summer Games in Tokyo, but in the Europa Cup they clinched the bronze medal, and they were in the semi-final in the World League as well. But over there they lost against Croatia by 2 goals, and for the third place they lost against Australia, so they finished fourth. By Croatia was in the final in the Europa Cup, but they lost against Hungary. In the World League Super Final, they also lost against Serbia by 1 goal. And in the World Championship, they finished third. So both teams had a great year last year. A steal, nothing happens at the referee, and we are under the last minute of the first quarter, and in this quarter, in this very first quarter, no goal for Spain and only one for Croatia. Very tight match, as it was expected. Both teams are defending really well, and if the defense lets an attacker to shoot, then there are the goalies Dani Lopez and Marko Vujačić. Both goalies are on top form. Under the last 30 seconds, only 20 now, and only 9 to attack for Spain. Mayera trying to pass to the center forward. Exclusion from Croatia. So in these last 12 seconds, Spain has the ball, and maybe they were just too quickly taken this chance. And as the Croatians holding the ball, this is how the first quarter ended. Only 1 goal, what we could see, and the goal scored. Greece. But both coaches said this will be a very entertaining match for the fans. And this had a huge crowd here in Duna Arena. Not yet a full house, but it will be surely for the second semi-final. Croatia has the ball, but only now for 5 seconds. Still passing, only 1 second, and this was a wrong pass to Macan, and Croatia is losing the ball. Now it's Sanauha. So it's Fernandez with the ball. Unaris. The Croatians are protesting, but what a shot from distance. The first goal for Spain and the top scorer of the tournament, Alvaro Granados, is the goal scorer. Maybe there was a little deflection from this angle, we will see. Yes, the hand of Xavi Garcia deflected a bit. But Alvaro Granados scores. He was the hero against Germany, scored 5 goals. Now he's on top form as well. Shot on the other side, and one more save for Dani Lopez. Granados has already 16 goals in the whole tournament. So 1-1. Let's see, in the beginning of the second quarter, the first Spanish goal, but this time saved by the post. Granados tried one more time. It deflected again, but went wide. Kovic. Now to the center forward position. Nothing happened. No foul given by the referees. There was Josip Vrlić, Croatian number 10. Just a free throw. Under 10 seconds for the Spanish team. Fernandez. Narumbe. Fernandez, shot from distance, went wide. No second goal for Spain. 3 years ago, Croatia won the World Championships gold medal. And from that team, from that 13 players, only 4 wasn't there, who are playing here in Budapest. Bukic, Milos, Vrlić and Benic. Now shot from distance, and Croatia takes the lead for the second time in the match. The captain, Andro Busilija, his 10th goal in the tournament. This was his first shot, and the team captain scored his first goal. He's 34 years old, he celebrated his 34th birthday this month, in the beginning of the month. Two-time world champion, one-time European champion, and he was there 8 years ago when Croatia won the Olympic gold as well. From that team, there is the answer from Spain, and this time De Toro. His 4th goal in Budapest. 2 goals apiece now. You could see the dribbling from De Toro. It was a mistake from defense. Andrea Busilia made it. Well, I just wanted to tell that from that Olympic gold medalist team, and actually from that team that won 10 years ago the only Croatian gold medal in the European Championships, only Busi and Djokovic are those players who are still here and playing for Croatia. On the other side, this time no goal for Croatia. Dani Lopez saves it. The shot of Fatović. Granados. Majera. Then a shot from distance, or this time saved by Marco Bijač. An exclusion from Spain, so 6-5. No, sorry, no exclusion. But now there is the exclusion. Number 3, Granados. His first personal foul in the game. Djokovic. Only 5 seconds for Croatia. And one more time, a wrong pass. And the time runs out for Croatia. So they just let the ball, but a turnover fall while swimming ahead the Spanish players. So the possession goes back to Croatia. Kovic. One more. Time there is a turnover foul against the Croatian player. The foul this time. Still only 2 goals for both teams. Now it's Majerak with the ball. And the shot from distance. And Spain takes the lead for the first time in the match with the goal of Munarriz. Roberto Munarriz, who scored 14 goals until this match, now he is on 15 goals. He and Perone scored 14 goals until the semi-final, while Granados 15. So Spain now, for the first time in the game, took the lead. This is Ante Vukicevic. He had already 3 shots and no goal. Exclusion from Spain. Number 7 is Delgado, who is playing for Brazil just like Perrone. Now the shot from the left wing, and goal number 3 for Croatia. So they equalized, and the goal scorer is Luka Bukic. Luka Bukic, whose sister Petra plays for the Croatian women's team, 25 years old. Of course, he's the older than Petra. And the reaction for this goal of the Croatian bench. Saneuha. Perone asks him the ball, and he got it. First he was Oh, what a beautiful pass, but a great save made by Marco Bihać. One more time. This was just a huge save. Perrone. Now shot from distance. Bihać again. This is already his seventh save. We are getting close to the last minute of the first half. And we saw only six goals so far. Perrone with the ball. Now Sanahuja, now to the center forward. And from there, an exclusion. The number 11, Hrubalja Benić, his second major foul. Perrone. Now to the right wing to Sanahuja. Granados is there. Now the shot and goal for Spain. Spain takes the lead again with the goal of Delgado. Adrián Delgado was competing for Brazil until 2016, but for 3 years now he is Spanish international. Reaction of the Spanish head coach David Martin, 44 years old, coaching the Spanish national team for 4 years now. Only 30 seconds left from the second quarter. And now there is an exclusion from Spain. But one more time, a wrong pass. They're losing seconds and sometimes even a chance to have a shot, the Croatians. Now pass to the right wing. And then there is a beautiful move. Wonderful assist. And the goal scored by Luka Lončar. From extra player, his first goal in the match, and the joy of the Croatian fans. We have 10 more seconds until the end of the second quarter. Shot from distance and went wide. But we have 1.5 seconds to go. Nothing happened in this very short period of time. So after two. Hungary, the Olympic they won the silver 4 years ago. Let's see the second half of the first semi-final in the 34th LAN European Water Polo Championships in the men's tournament, and Croatia won the sprint. That means they have the possession, they have the chance to take the lead. You can see they won all the sprints so far. Now it's Vukicevic, just a free throw, only 3 seconds left for Croatia. And a save made by Dani Lopez one more time. Xavi Garcia with the ball. Now Jokovic. Now to the center forward, nothing happens, said the referee. From Croatia, the number 7, Vukicevic, already his second personal foul. Now the Spanish players are passing until the last moment, and now they almost won the ball back. Garcia. Exclusion from Spain. This is Bustos' second major foul. That's Bukic. Passing the ball, only 4 seconds for Croatia, only 2 now, there is a block. And the rebound went back to Croatia, that means the time clock starts from 20 seconds. This was a huge mistake. So now Spain have the chance to take the lead again. But they were leading 4-3. Now there is a chance for a shot. Not this time. And now there is a shot and the block. Still no goal in this third quarter. Still 4-4. There's a goal for Spain. Goal number 5 for the Spaniards. And the goal scorer is Alberto Munarriz. His second goal in the match. This time from distance. You can see one more time why this goal was disallowed, and on the other side, the Spanish team managed to score their 5th goal. Jokovic. Pass back from Miloš. Exclusion, Granados, his second major foul. Miloš, now to the left wing, one more time. Not perfect pass. Croatians are losing time. There is a shot. And once again, Dani Lopez saves it. This was his 10th save from 14 shots, 71%. While Marko Bijač now is on less than 60% from 12 shots. He saved 7. Now Munar Riz. Shot from distance. There is a block from Croatia. Trying to make the fast break, but no need because the Croatian head coach Ivica Tucak asking his timeout.
Dođi. Mate, momci, nemojte mu šutirati oko glave, ljudi, to jedino brani, ej. Dalje, stali smo, pali smo u ritmu. Počeli smo krivo dodavati loptu, nemamo sigurnost u napadu. Radimo ono što smo se dogovorili od početka. Široko, ej, kad formiraju M zonu, ulazak, krila, pomicanje vanjskog igrača. Točno dodavanje, gledajmo gol, ej. Hajmo!
Croatia has the ball. Only 22% shooting efficiency for Croatia and 25 for Spain. But okay, this is not about scoring lots of goals, but winning the match, winning the semi-final and reach the final. This is Macan, and Miloš, and one more time, a block. This is the third block for Spain. Croatia has 4. Under 10 seconds for the Spanish team on the shot clock, and nothing happens at the referee, so Croatia has the possession. There was no one to pass to Marko Bijač. That's why he needed to wait for a long time. Cirkovic. Then a shot, and what a goal from this tight angle. Croatia equalize one more time, and the goal scorer is the number 9, Lovre Miloš. His first goal from his 6th shot. Changing players on both teams. This was the 8th goal for Miloš in Budapest. Munar Riz. Very far from the Croatian goal. Now there was no exclusion, but now this is Macan's 2nd personal foul. And there is a great goal, and the goal scorer is Felipe Perrone. He only scored his first goal today. The captain of the Spanish team, 33 years old, 2-time World Silver medalist, and European bronze medalist as well, plus silver, of course. last year, sorry, in the last European Championships 2 years ago. Now Spain takes the lead one more time, 6-5. Exclusion from Spain. Munarriz is first. Now the chance on the left side, and then just pass Fatovic. There is a shot. There were even some blocks as well, and saved by the crossbar too. Now to the left again, and from there is no chance for Dani Lopez to save it. Croatia equalize again. Luka Bukic, his second goal. From Croatia, he is the first player who has more than one goal. From Spain, it's Munarriz, who scored two times. Free throw for Spain. No exclusion from the Croatian team until now. From the center forward position, this is Busilia. And his first major foul in the match. And there was the chance, but there was a touch of Marko Bihać. And now, no chance for the fast break for Croatia. The Croatian fans just chanting the name of the Croatian goalie. Only 10 seconds for Croatia to the center forward, and now there is an exclusion. De Toro. Javi Garcia with the ball. It's Jokovic. Back to Garcia. Only 5 seconds for Croatia. And there was one more mistake, and then the shot saved by the post. And the rebound with the help of the referee goes back to Javi Garcia. Only 25 seconds to go in this third quarter. Still tied game. Spain 6, Croatia 6. Both teams are really playing until the last second for the shot. There is a block. And then Dani Lopez collecting the ball in the last second of the third quarter. This ended in a draw, 2-2 in this 8 minutes. First quarter, won by Croatia. 8 minutes. If in the end of the fourth quarter still tied, then there will be penalty shootouts. It looks like this time Spain won the sprint. Granada's made it. This is just the first and last time, of course, when Spain won the sprint. Both teams are defending really tight, pushing the forwards far from their goal. But now there is an exclusion from Croatia. And Andrea Busilia, his second major foul. This is Perrone on the left wing now. It is Granados, and he scores! Just the top scorer in the Spanish team here in Budapest, Álvaro Granados. And this time on a man advantage. He scores his second goal in the match from four shots. Already on 17 goals here in Budapest. David Martin, who was a great player as well, not just a great coach. He won 2 times the World Championship bronze medal and 1 time the European Championship bronze medal for Spain. Now it's Vukicevic. Vukicevic again. Then Jokovic. Jokovic from distance. And I think he just hit his teammate, Luka Lončar. First time, it can be a 2-goal lead for Spain. Only 3 seconds for Spain to finish the attack, and a turnover foul in the center forward position. So Spain is losing the ball. And now this is Jokovic. Exclusion from Spain this time. Felipe Perrone's first major foul in the game. Vukicevic. Then a shot from Jokovic, and he scores. Maro Jokovic, his first goal from 3 shots. And Croatia equalize again. We can be sure that the Croatians will come back until they are able to fight. Seven goal apiece. And now here in Duna Arena is almost a full house. Not ready for this match, but after this match we have Hungary against Montenegro, the second semi-final. And it's Munariz. Munariz to the center forward. Now there was the chance to pass, and what a move from there. And the goal scorer is Roger Tahul, his first goal of the match. Beautiful move from Tahul, his 8th goal in the tournament, and this is number 8 for Spain. He beat his defender. Benic. Jokovic is asking the ball, but now Bukic got it. Only 15 seconds for Croatia. Very far from the Spanish goal, Benic. Back to Benic, and his shot went wide. Now the second time for Spain that they have the chance to increase the lead to 2 goals. Perrone waiting for the ball. There can be a steal, yes, because this way there is a turnover foul. So Croatia got back the ball, and there was still a pair next to the Croatian goal fighting, but the referee said nothing happened there. Miloš. Miloš trying to steal the distance, but he didn't see, didn't realize that Sanahuja just arrived and he's just steal the ball. And team timeout called by the Spanish head coach David Martin. It was a very important steal which made by Sanahuja.
Vale, para meter el lanzamiento de falta. Vale, ¿puedo usar la entrada mejor? Sí. Dí que estén atentos a la entrada, porque si me da la vida, la veo la entrada. Eso es muy bien. Vale, vale. Queda partido, chicos. Oye, nos vamos con Álvaro en 5, ¿vale? Y Muna en 4. Hacemos la 3-4, que salga Álvaro, ¿vale? Y Muna te vas de doble boya. ¿Entendido? ¿Vale? Vas a tres hacia el otro lado, ¿de acuerdo? ¿Vale, chicos? Sí.
Venga, va, chaval.
Adri, descansa, Magnat, continúa. Garumbe. 1-2. Vale, vale. Magnat, Magnat.
4 minutes and 18 seconds to go in this first semi-final. And Spain has the lead and has the chance to increase it to 2 goals. Of course, this is a very crucial moment. That's why David Martin asked the timeout. Both coaches have one more. And there is a shot and a block made by Miloš. Here's the block again. Now Xavi Garcia is looking for someone to pass the ball. Miloš. Xavi Garcia now in the middle, and the shot from there. I have to say, for me, it looked like an easy save for Dani Lopez. This was his 12th save so far. More than 60% for Dani Lopez. Now this is Munariz passing to the center forward. Just a free throw, no exclusion. Shot from distance, Granados tried, but this time he had no luck, no goal. Only 21 years old, but he already a world and European silver medalist, Alvaro Granados. And he can be easily a top scorer here in Budapest. But now Croatia has the chance to equalize. Fatović. Only 4 seconds, and a block made by Munariz. Only 1 goal for Croatia in this quarter and 2 for Spain. That's why Spain is leading by 1 goal, 8-7. Granados to the center forward, and now there is the exclusion from Croatia. Nacan is out from the game with his third exclusion. Granados. Now to the left wing. Verona passing to the right, and a block. The Croatians are trying to make that fast break, but Ivica Tusak is asking and calling the team timeout. His second.
Andro ide u prvu liniju. U prvu liniju. Prolazak po liniji i širimo se za jedno mjesto u desnu stranu. Pazimo ovaj početni pressing da nam ne idu preko glave, okej? Okay. Prolazak i onda je bitno da sredina ulazi u među prostor. Ej, moramo gledat gol, Ante. Lolo, lolo.
One minute and 47 seconds from the match. Spain is leading by one goal, 8-7, against Croatia in the first semi-final. Jokovic. Huge battle in the center forward position, still no exclusion. Croatians are passing the ball. One more time again, until they have the chance to pass to the center forward. That was Vrlić. And now there is an exclusion from Spain. 6-5 now. Javi Garcia. Vukicevic, shot from distance and saved by Dani Lopez. If Spain scores from this attack, they will win the match. What a save made by the best goalie of the world. Now it's Perrone. If Spain don't score, Croatia has one more attack time. This is Munariz. Only 1 second, and the ball went in. The ball went in, and the referee said this was a good goal. Ivica Tusak is saying he wants to check this. I mean, asking the referee to check this on the video if it was still on time or not. Munariz made the shot, and what is sure, it went in. The question is, when Munariz made the shot, and the referee said it's a good goal. So Spain is leading by 2 goals. They need to score quickly and somehow steal the ball. Now there is a quick goal scored by Vukicevic. 9-8, 20 seconds to go. 20 seconds to go. Spain needs only to hold the ball. Navi Martin has one more chance for a timeout. He's not calling it. Spain just needs to hold the ball, and they are in the final. For the second time after Barcelona. So second time in a row, I mean. Perrone with the ball. Only 10 seconds. Under 10 seconds now, and Perrone is swimming to the corner. No chance for Xavi Garcia to reach him. Perrone just passing back. Spain is in the final after winning against Croatia 9-8. What a semi-final it was. And David Martin coached his team for the third time in a row into a huge, big tournament. 2 years ago in Barcelona. They lost against Serbia on the penalty shootout.